Before today, the Democrats had been hell-bent on taking over the House, but with Justice Kennedy saying he's out, the Senate is in very sharp focus, as is a set of tough questions about who the Democrats are. Joining us now, perfect timing, DNC Chair Tom Perez. Tom, thank you for being with us on what has turned out to be a huge day. I have to talk to you about the reverberations to the plans for the House and who just won here in New York, what it means about your party. But, this headline that just shifts all intensity to the Senate, Justice Kennedy, maybe the most impactful decision he has made is when to retire, and that decision comes today. How does this change the stakes for your party?
Well, our strategy has always been the same, Chris. We're organizing everywhere. We competed in Alabama last year. People thought we were kind of nuts because Democrats can't win down there. We always understood that in the world of Trump, we had to be prepared for consequences just like this. That's why we've been organizing early and organizing everywhere. And quite frankly, you know, we're at an inflection point in our nation's journey to form a more perfect union. And what we have to do now is what we've been doing throughout, which is get people out to vote.
But the stakes, Tom, you know, for all of Trump's talk about what he wants to do, Judge Gorsuch and the other judges that are being put through the Senate with McConnell's help, that's his big impact. How big is this judicial appointment in terms of the future path and the partisan trajectory of this country?
Well, it's undeniably important, Chris, and that's why we're fighting like heck. And we're going to hold them to the standard they held Democrats to. In 2016, Mitch McConnell said you shouldn't consider a nomination during an election year. Well, this is an election year.
Are the Dems able to stall a vote?
Well, what we're going to do is make sure we uphold the Constitution. I think there's bipartisan consensus that Roe v. Wade is the law of the land. And if you nominate a judge to the Supreme Court who is not going to uphold Roe v. Wade, that should trigger overwhelmingly bipartisan opposition. And so what we're going to continue to do fight for the Constitution, and we're going to make sure that we're doing our level best. And
Tom,
we need more Democrats, no doubt about it.
I get that that's got to be your goal. You're running the DNC. But, you know, Tom, that's how elections have consequences. We just saw with the Janus case, the union and collective bargaining and what that means for public unions. That was stare decisis, too. That was former precedent. Judges can change decisions if they want to. And this court has shown that inclination. So Roe v. Wade is only as good as this bench says it is. The question is, what can you do about it?
Well, we can win elections, Chris, and that's what
But can you take the Senate?
Oh, absolutely. We've got
Which
opportunities.
Because you got some people who are vulnerable, too. Red state Democrats.
Well, hey, here's the deal, Chris. We've got opportunities in Nevada. We've got opportunities in Arizona. We've got opportunities in Tennessee, an opportunity in Mississippi, opportunity in Texas. Five states right there where we have opportunities.
I'll give you three of those five where you got a shot, but you have a couple where you're vulnerable also. And do you think those senators, the Joe Manchin category of Democrat, do you think they'll step up and stall a vote even though it could hurt them at home?
Well, listen, you know, health care is a right for all and not a privilege for a few. That is in danger with this Supreme Court. And we have seen Democratic solidarity on issues of health care. And the thing that we have going for us in the Senate races this year, Chris, in the states where we're playing defense, is that we've got a spectacular stable of incumbent Democrats. And that is why I have a lot of optimism that we can take over the Senate.
All right, let me ask you one political question while I have you here on the House side. This race in New York and this young woman, 28 years old, who beat a 10-term congressman in Joe Crowley, that matters. She represents things that are decidedly different than a lot of people in your party. She is left. And she might be left of Bernie Sanders on some issues, saying that ICE has to go. Is that a reflection of who your party will be across the country?
Listen, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez ran a spectacular campaign. And as a Latino, it's inspiring to see another Latina run and win. And she ran because she was focused on the issues that people in her community cared about. Just as when Connor Lamb won a few months ago, he was focused on the issues that mattered to people in his districts. And we've been winning elections, Chris, statewide elections, congressional elections, state legislative elections, mayoral, et cetera, because our candidates have been laser focused on healthcare, laser focused on immigration, as Alexandria was doing.
But
laser
her solutions, Tom, on Medicare for all, her solutions on immigration, get rid of ICE, are those things that the party will adopt as a platform, or are you going to leave it to district by district, make the choices that work for you as a candidate?
Well, listen, we believe as Democrats that health care is a right for all and not a privilege for a few. We certainly have a debate about how to get there, and there are differences of opinion among Democrats. Joe Crowley, who has had a distinguished career in Congress, was a proponent of the Medicare for All proposal. So we're going to have, I think what's most important is where we are united as Democrats.
Are you united doesn't mean on unanimity. Single payer? Are you united on that? Is Medicare for All the Democrat position?
We are united on the fact that health care must be a right for all and not a privilege for a few. And
right,
we
but
have
what does
been
that
winning
mean? What model are you going to adopt, Tom? Are you going
to
adopt single
payer?
There's
many different ways. There's many different ways, Chris, to get there.
Single payer is a hot button for a reason. I keep saying it for a reason, Tom. I understand the economics. I understand the logistics of it. We're all doing our homework on the journalism side to understand this, and it's very complex. But to voters, what that will signal is a cost shifting that will make health care from the government perspective a lot more of a heavy lift. It's going to cost a lot more money if you go to single payer. And I just want to know, where's your head in terms of whether or not that's where your party is, single payer?
No, our party is, I think, very clear, which is that we believe that health care is a right for all and not a privilege for a few. Yes, we're having a debate on how to get there. But what's important to know is the Republicans are having a debate on how to move the ball backward. They want less people to have access to health care. They don't believe that a pre-existing condition matters, that you can be denied insurance coverage for that. And
that does seem to be on the table for them right now. It's true.
And that's why this nomination matters. There's so much at stake. And I think the most important thing Democrats can do is don't fret about this. We got to fight back. We've got to organize and we've got to vote.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's no longer hypothetical. This is an existential battle in terms of political realities, and it's all going to come down to November, and there's going to be a big eye on the Senate. Tom Perez, thank you very much for joining me.
It's been a pleasure to be with you, Chris.